Eduardo De Filippo in Palestinian style had not yet been seen. A bold undertaking, stage in Ramallah. Ihab Halawa, the director of the shortened version, was the first to translate Uomo e Galantuomo into Arabic. For the first time being, it has been performed in Neapolitan and summarized in Arabic by non-professional actors, Italians and Palestinians who are studying the Italian language in the West Bank. Eduardo De Filippo makes his theatre a social complaint. In Uomo e Galantuomo, he speaks of pride, madness, appearance in society. These are themes that can be adapted in the Arab world. Where adaptation is less easy, Ihab used poetic license, as in the case of the betrayal of the husband by Bice, the lover of Don Alberto, the protagonist of the comedy. It has been described as adultery, but without sexual intercourse. This has been taken away because of the sensitivity of the Palestinian culture, a rather religious culture in which, therefore, a lot of attention is paid to marriage, the relationship within marriage, but not outside. A work promoted by the Dante Alighieri Society of Ramallah, and not easy for Ihab, a Palestinian Christian who had the opportunity to study tourism and entertainment at the University of Messina. My way of seeing things has changed a bit because art is a form of resistance in Palestine. Even just getting people out of the political situation, laughing, is an important step. To tell the truth, but does Eduardo De Filippo's Neapolitan make sense in Arabic? The translation was made in Palestinian dialect, not in classic Arabic. Translating some Neapolitan terms such as wata was difficult. So yes, it lacks some of its original meaning in Arabic.